Hello everybody, I am Ryan, and welcome back to Primetime Horror, and today's video is going to be a very different one. I don't normally do videos like this, but I'm going to the Halloween 45th anniversary convention, Halloween 45 Years of Terror. It's super fun. I'm filming this after the fact because I didn't have enough time to film an intro before I went there, but I had a blast. This is going to be an awesome video. I met a bunch of cool people, I seen a bunch of cool stuff, it's just an awesome video, and stay tuned to the very end where I show you all of the things I got, signatures, just general merchandise and whatnot, because I also got a lot of cool stuff as well. So stay tuned for that, and yeah, I hope you guys enjoy.
What the dog doing? Look for her. Come here.
All right, pimps, so we're out here getting some food because I am starving. Here I have Bakers. I don't know if people in the West Coast or wherever else in America you're watching this has Bakers, but it's very good. So here and then the convention we go.
Here's a scenic shot of trees.
All right, you guys, we are here at the Pasadena Convention Center. It is sprinkling a little bit, which sucks, but there's a giant Michael Myers here, which is awesome. So yeah, about to be lit.
I guess America's Got Talent is right next door. What are the odds? We got Resurrection Michael right there, H2O Michael right there, Halloween 6 Michael right there, other Halloween 6 Michael, and so on. We got Halloween 5 Michael, dude from Halloween, oh hell yeah, we got Ken Foray of 3 over here, badass. A bunch of people from around town. Hell yeah, look, we got Malcolm McDowell up in this line stretching to Mars.
Got more people from Rob Zombie's Halloween. We got Tyler Mane. Alright, you guys, so my goal right now is to find someone that I actually want to meet. And it's like a maze around here, so that's going to be a little tough. But yeah, we're on the prowl.
Well, found Dick Warlock. That's what I'm going for next.
Okay, never mind. Turns out he's actually at a panel right now, so I guess we're just gonna have to meet him later. But here's Danielle Harris. So looks like that's who we're meeting.
Damn, we got a whole gang of Michaels pulling up on me. They approach him.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
What you got for me?
Blu-ray.
Got it. Do you want your name on it?
Oh, yeah.
What's your name?
Ryan. And you're my favorite female horror, so this is pretty cool.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So sweet.
The answer is yes. Is that just the phone?
All right, you guys, so I just met Danielle Harris, and she was very, very sweet, as I expected her to be. I got my Scream Factory Blu-ray signed by her, which I will show off at the end of the video. So stay tuned for that. I'm going to be showing off everything I got. So, yeah, go on to the next. Okay, so now I'm gonna try to find Trick or Treat Studios because I really want to get a Rob Zombie's Halloween mask. They just came out, they're at basically every store, and I am hoping they have them here. If not, then maybe a Leatherface mask because I don't have any of those yet. So yeah, stay tuned. Okay, I wish I was filming just now, but I just walked past the Malcolm McDowell himself. And bro casually looked at me and nodded his head at me. So that means we're best friends now. So I guess you could say I'm best friends with Malcolm McDowell. He looked at me. So yeah, we're best friends now. All right, you guys, we just acquired the Rob Zombie's Halloween 2 Dream Sequence Trick or Treat Studios mask. So if you want a good look at that, stay tuned to the end of the video. And I think I want to meet someone else next, so let's do it. All right, so I want to meet Dick Warlock or Nick Castle, but both of their lines are like insanely long, like stretching basically across the entire building. And the other person I wanted to meet, Marianne something, she was the lead girl in Halloween 6. She's literally just not here. Like, I've looked everywhere and she's just like vanished. Maybe her flight got delayed. It doesn't say she was canceled on the website, so I'm not sure. I guess if I can't find her, I'll get, I forget his name, but he played Michael in Halloween 6. The other guy, not George P. Wilbur, because, you know, he died, RP. So, yeah, after the panel for the original 1978 Halloween, I'm gonna go back to Dick Warlock and Nick Castle to see if maybe their lines died down. If not, then I don't know if I'm gonna be meeting them this time. So I just had one of the strangest experiences of my life. I'm here at Halloween 45 and I walked outside to take a breath because it's hot as hell in here. And this girl that I've never met before, I don't know her, she kept staring at me all weird. And I didn't know why at first. Then she starts flipping out and is like, oh my god, you look exactly like my friend, blah, 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 blah. And she like had me take a picture to show her friend and she asked for my Instagram. So, I mean, I guess you could say I rizzed her up without even trying. Got the Instagram and everything. Shit crazy. Okay, brother, what? Random ass fit. That shit crazy. Alright you guys, I didn't get to film it, but I did just get to meet Chase Wright Bannick, who played little young Michael in Rob Zombie's Halloween 2. He's super nice, and I got a signature from him, but you'll have to wait to the end of the video to see it, just like with all the other stuff, so stay tuned. About to go to Vinegar Syndrome and see if they have a zombie on 4K. I've been looking for that for a while. Let's see. Oh,
that's always a nice thing.
Can I get this? How much again?
40.
Okay. Alright, you guys, I just got the Vinegar Syndrome 4K of Lucio Fulci's Zombie. And I also got a really cool Cavity Colors t-shirt for a Halloween movie, but I'm saving to show you guys those until the end of the video, so stay tuned for that. But right now, we are going into the Halloween 1978 panel where, you know, all the actors and stuff are going to be talking about the movie, so that's going to be awesome.
Ivan and myself, who lived at the West, I felt that it's my obligation, my duty to tell the truth about Islam.
Mustafa reminds me of Gandhi in so many ways, of having this dream to achieve something.
We can be honest with each other about the
perfect embodiment of everything that represents the holiday. There's something about the way evil is personified in this film that is completely timeless. Sadly, the synopsis of this movie reads like a CNN headline these days, but there's an underlying mythology, even in the simplicity of the story, that keeps us coming back for more every year. And we all showed up today for it. I'm very honored to introduce this cast today, and I want to hear you guys tear the roof off this place as we bring them up, okay?
Yeah!
She totally impressed us with her famous squealing, the beautiful Kiko.
To get milk and never came back.
Here's a guy that made children in clown costumes horrifying until the end of time. Ladies and gentlemen, Will Sandin. Performance reminded us all that nudity in horror films will be the first thing that's punished. And her headstone was apparently light enough to carry across town and up some stairs. The gorgeous Sandy Johnson.
This shit about to go crazy.
The OG Boogeyman.
Yeah.
There's only one of them. From the band The Coupe de Villes, ladies and gentlemen, Nick Castle.
And John obviously can see it. You want to do this part? And I went, absolutely. I should have said totally. Why'd you pick me? And he said, because you're the only one that read the word totally right. And I said, well, how else would you say it? He said, well, that's why you got the part. And then he asked me to wait to help him select the three guys, someone to play my boyfriend. And I fell in love with John Michael Graham, and I said, he's my Bob.
Hello. It's going good.
All right.
A great time. I was wondering if you could sign this.
Sure.
Yeah. Anywhere's fine.
Okay. Am I the only one signing this?
Yep.
You want me to write Michael Myers? It's already on there. Just H6?
Yeah, that's good.
H6?
Yep.
Okay. Perfect.
Yeah, I think Halloween 6 gets way too much hate.
Yeah, I don't get it.
I think it's a really fun
movie. I like my kill scenes.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Your kill scenes are some of the best.
I think so.
Your kill scenes are some of the best in the franchise, especially that one right there.
Yeah.
That one's awesome. All right, you guys. So we just finished the Halloween 1978 panel. And after that, I went ahead and met Michael A. Lerner, who played Michael Myers in the Halloween 6 reshoots for the theatrical version. So whenever you watch the theatrical version, most of the Michael is him. So he was really fun to meet. He was really sweet. I actually forgot to pay, and he completely didn't notice. But of course, I went back and paid him. And yeah, it was fun. I really wanted to meet Dick Warlock, but his line was absolutely insane. I mean, it was even longer than Nick Castle's. Like, it was crazy. And then I wanted to meet Nick Castle, but his line also went on for days. So sadly, didn't get to meet either of them, but I did get to meet three absolutely awesome people, and I also picked up a lot of cool stuff. So I'm going home, and I'll show you guys everything I got when I get there. So yeah, that is going to do it for Halloween 45. Alright, so thank you if you made it to the end of the video, and now we're at the part where I show you everything I got. So, I guess starting us off is this really cool signature from the guy who played little kid Michael in Rob Zombie's Halloween 2. He was a very, very nice guy. Probably the coolest person I met. There wasn't many people at his table, and I kind of felt bad, so I went up to him and I got a signature and a picture from him. I probably put that in the video as well. But yeah, this is really cool. It's also a pretty cool shot of him in the movie too. So yeah, that's very awesome. Okay, so the next thing I got is something I already had, the Halloween 6 Producer's Cut Blu-ray. But I got it signed by A. Michael Lerner, who played Michael in a good majority of Halloween 6, because they had to go back and do a lot of reshoots, as I'm sure most of you know. And in all those reshoots, he played Michael. So yeah, he was a very, very nice guy, as I'm sure you guys saw in the video. And yeah, it's sad that we lost George P. Wilbur last year. I would have got him to sign this as well. But, you know, A. Michael Lerner was very, very nice, and I'm glad I got his signature. Very cool Blu-ray, too. I'm glad I have that as well. And the next one is, again, something I already had but got signed. I met Danielle Harris from Halloween 4, 5, Rob Zombie's Halloween 1 and 2. You know, she's been in, like, an insane amount of movies. But I got her to sign my not Trick or Treat Studios, my Scream Factory Halloween 4 4K, as you can see there. Very cool. She did it in orange marker, wrote my name and everything. Pretty cool. Yeah, she was great to meet. You know, there was a crap ton of people in her line, so I had to be pretty fast paced, but you know, she was very nice, as I expected her to be. And yeah, very, very cool signature. This is even without the signature, this is an awesome release, but with the signature, it just makes it that much better. So that is very cool. Okay, I also got this. This is from a booth that was there. This guy who made a movie called Hellvan. He signed it himself, which is very cool. And there's a piece of the script inside of the case, the script from the actual movie, which is pretty cool. And I guess it was only $10, which, you know, is, I mean, dude was basically giving it away for free. See, everything's highlighted still. It's very, very cool. I haven't seen the movie yet, but I'm definitely going to be watching it. And even if I don't end up liking it, you know, the dude was still a really nice guy. And, you know, it's still cool that he was, you know, at the convention giving these away for so cheap. So that was a cool little extra thing. And those are all the signed things I got. But I did get a few more other things that aren't signed, just from like the booths and whatnot. So next I got is, what is this? Blue Underground's 4K of Lucille Fulci's Zombie. I've been wanting this for a while. I had it in my cart on Amazon, and I seen they had it there, and I had to get it because, I mean, Lucille Fulci is an absolutely amazing director, and this is by far one of the best zombie horror movies of all time. I mean, it's great. It's very good. I haven't even opened it yet, so yeah. Glad to finally have this. I've been wanting that for a while. Okay, so the next thing I got, memorabilia-wise, is a Cavity Colors Halloween 4, The Return of Michael Myers shirt. You know, I was gonna go to Fright Rags to get a shirt, but their line was insanely long, and I think Cavity Colors has equally as cool designs. And so I just went to their line, and really cool people at that line too. Like, the lady was asking me, you know, what my favorite movie in the franchise was, and that she thinks that this movie doesn't get enough love. And yeah, just really nice people there. And as you can see, it is a very, very cool design. Glad to have it. I don't have any kind of like boutique label type of shirts. I usually just get my shirts from like big companies. So this is, you know, very cool thing to have. I'm glad to have it. Now, this next and final thing is something that I have been wanting ever since it was announced, and I was hoping that they would have it there, and they did. This is the Trick or Treat Studios Rob Zombie's Halloween 2 Dream Sequence mask, and yeah, this thing is absolutely awesome. Look at that. It's got a really rough texture to it, which I was hoping, since this is a very rough, dirty mask in the movie. I didn't want it to be all nice and pretty and glossy looking. You know, they did, you know, perfect with like making the blood look caked on and gross and glossy, but making everything else look, you know, natural, how it's supposed to look. And yeah, as you guys can see, this thing looks absolutely awesome, and the hair is great too. It's not those just strips of wig or anything. It's actually like, I don't know, it's like put on there very, very good. And yeah, as you can see, this thing is absolutely awesome. Yeah, Trick or Treat Studios had like basically every Michael Myers mask they had there, and I would have got this one and the other two that they have, but I didn't have enough money for that, but I'll definitely get those eventually. But yeah, this one was my favorite one, and so I picked it up. And yeah, as you can see, it is very, very cool. Okay, so that is it for everything I got at that convention, and yeah, the convention was a blast. I was very, very happy to go there, and yeah, I met a lot of cool people, and you know, it was just overall fun. And if you made it to the end of the video, I hope you enjoyed, and YouTube is about to copyright my entire bloodline with this video because of how much music I use. So if you're seeing this, please make sure you subscribe if you're not subscribed, and like the video. So, thank you very much for watching. This has been Primetime Horror. I am Ryan, signing off. See you later.